I'm going to play it real time so you can see the game. Now watch here as I apply transitions. The reason I did that is I want you to kind of understand those transitions are also GPU intensive. So watch what I'm doing in making my own little movie here, where I'm going from Gears of War to the other first party game called Gigantic, both played on the Surface Book. Did you see that transition, how smooth it is? For those of you who understand Premiere Pro, we didn't skip one frame, and we were in full GPU rendering.
The Microsoft / Windows 10 event was a bit meh on most parts, but I enjoyed how they are really pushing their hardware onto their devices, which is really good of them compared to my very crud PC these days. But however, I'm really looking forward to at the beginning of December when they do release Windows 10 Mobile for devices such as my Microsoft Lumia, which I'm looking forward to. But overall, it was a good, you know, event. It's a vlog. That Microsoft Surface Book has made me kind of a bit jelly, and even though with my crud PC, you know, let alone my PC, it's very, very old. It has very old specs from years in the past and all that. It's like very old. I think it's like in 2007, 2008. I can't remember the date, but it's very, very old, so to say. But me and my mum recently discussed about maybe getting a new PC, maybe for Christmas for me, really, but I don't know what I want for Christmas, but I would like a new PC. But my mum and I had recent conversations, but I'll mention how it goes in the coming months to go. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Morgan, Steety Films, it's a vlog. So, what videos I did this past 1 week? Even though I only did the one particular video this past 1 week, even though the past few weeks I've been doing quite a few videos, it's nice to just do just the one video, I guess. Even though I kind of had plans on getting Rock Band 4 this past 1 week, since it came out this past 1 week, but there was a bit of a slight issue because they only kind of did limited stocks, not only just in the UK, maybe in the US as well. But this past 1 week I was going to get Rock Band 4, but I went to my local stores. Even though I have been doing some good old research, let alone keeping tabs on the good old internet, thanks internet, and keeping tabs on my local stores and what they have, even like say Tesco's, Asda's, or like Sainsbury's, or any sort of stores like that didn't have it, had it on their sites. And then during launch, I went to loads of different local stores to try and find the game. Even a particular store, gaming store, that I rarely go to buy my games, let alone gain some Microsoft credit. But other than that though, it's just they didn't have it in stock anywhere locally in my local area, so I didn't end up getting Rock Band 4 in the end, which is sadly to say. But however, despite though, after not getting Rock Band 4, I was quite a bit annoyed, mostly because I was really saved up for that game that I wanted to get, but I was really disappointed. But however, I might end up using whatever that I saved up, maybe get a few essential things that I might get in the coming weeks to come, like some certain pickups I got this week, regardless, let alone I might get some other things today, next week, and etc. stuff. But I'll mention some stuff to the weeks to come. But however, it was sadly to say didn't do Rock Band 4, but yeah, I'll just put whatever money's towards it, including I forgot to mention, put the rest towards Halo 5. I'm not going to get the limited edition, but we'll see the outcome in the following weeks to come. So I didn't end up doing Rock Band 4. But however, the Star Wars Battlefront beta has came out this past 1 week, and I did some gameplay for you guys, even though I kind of did the stupid thing, and I'm staying up late at night till midnight, as I usually do when certain things launch. And I thought it would be launched at midnight, so to say, but that was I was kind of regretting myself on staying up, let alone I should have done some proper research on the internet. Thanks, internet. But other than that, though, during the morning on the beta launch day, I read up on the internet that Australia and Japan had a copy of the beta. So I did a little thing, and that is went on the Australian region and used my US account to purchase my copy of the beta, and then during the day everyone else got it at 3 p.m. in the UK, and it was nice, however, to get some hands-on time during the morning. I maxed up my level as well as did some
good gameplay for you guys, and they didn't actually rush the gameplay, and ended up doing some gameplay for you guys, because usually the Hoth level on the beta is usually very packed, because it's, you know, 40 players and whatnot, and it's very, and I managed not to die most times, and then managed to do some good gameplay for you guys, let alone I tried to do the Luke Skywalker type thing, or Darth Vader, either way. But I couldn't do any gameplay of that because I didn't know how to do it. But after when I did some gameplay of the beta, I tried it, even though I didn't manage to do any kills with the heroes. But overall, in a nutshell, I enjoyed playing the beta. I'm looking forward to playing most things with the beta this weekend with someone, maybe. But other than that, though, yeah, just great beta overall. But overall, that's the videos I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I thought I'd show some pickups I've got this past 1 week. Even on the last vlog, it was just a few last week, even though it was just a Blu-ray and mostly shopping bags. Woo! Shopping bags! So exciting! The reason why I was doing that was because of a certain comment I got. But, you know, whatever. But let alone, I was only just doing that as a PSA, let alone I was just showing some of the new bags that I got since the Halloween carrier bag type thing. You know, that's been happening last week, even though it started this week and whatnot. But it's funny, because this past 1 week when I went to my local shops, like supermarkets, like Asda's, Tesco's and Sainsbury's, and all that hybrid with stuff, I see loads of people buying loads of life bags. Well, I do not know if the life bags were 5p or the actual, I don't know. But it was just a funny week overall, since the whole, you know, 5p carrier bag type malarkey, let alone I was trying to give out a PSA, let alone, you know, buying, oh, shopping bags, so exciting. Anyways, but however, for this vlog, I thought I'd show off some pickups I got this week. And since after when I did my vlog and last week also, I mentioned about the Amiibo cards, because you can use Amiibo cards in Mario Maker. And I thought, oh, might as well get a pack, even though that was saving up for Rock Band 4. But anyways, I managed to get some Amiibo cards. So yes, I actually got two packs of Amiibo cards, which is great. I will show you what I've got, but I'll show you one of them that I was really surprisingly got in the second pack. But yes, I actually got two packs of Amiibo cards, and they were quite cheap in Argos, because I did mention this in a few of my videos, that Argos was doing them for £3.50, because I went to the other Argos during the launch of them, Animal Crossing Happy Home Designer, and they didn't have any. So after when I did my vlog last week and went to the other Argos that I have in my local area, and they had loads of stock in, so I managed to get two packs worth, even though when other places like Smith's are doing it for £5, like the other gaming store that's doing it for £5 also, but they were doing them for £3.50 in Argos, so I got in two packs, so it saves about £3 than it is buying two packs for £10 in other stores, and I got two packs in Argos for £7, which is not bad buy. But yeah, overall it's just nice to get some Amiibo cards. But the one surprising one I was really pleased of was the shame that I didn't get Isabella, which I would like to get, but which I heard that I do not know if that was super rare or whatever. But anyways, I actually got Tom Nook, which is the second kind of a rarest amiibo card. But yes, I got the second Amiibo card, which is Tom Nook, which is brilliant. So yeah, I'm actually pleased with that. So yeah, it's a nice Amiibo card overall, and I used him in Mario Maker, and it's great though. And I realised that the special cards only work on Super Mario Maker. But the other thing is though, if you have any common cards, like the special cards, you can actually use them on the Amiibo touch and play thing, you know, where you play NES and Super Nintendo games on that. It's easy unlocks by using Amiibo cards, which is really, really good of Nintendo to kind of do that as like a easy way to unlock stuff on the Amiibo type thing. You need to put some new games on that app thing. But yeah, it's just a nice, easy unlock overall. Anyways, enough about Amiibo cards now. So when I shopped around, even though I lapped twice around town just to see what prices they do for the Amiibo cards, and I went to my local Asda's, and I mentioned a few vlogs back they were doing a big clearance and whatnot, and I realised they were doing some more things in clearance because they have a separate shelf and they got like some other type of stuff they want to get rid of, let alone I noticed that they might be changing the things to make room for, of course, the newer games and whatnot. I'm trying to clear out as much as they can, but it's just that I actually ended up getting the game in the end, and I wanted to get this game for quite a while, let alone my sister in general really wants to play this, and I actually got Just Dance 2015. Now I'm sure I have the last year's one of that, even though that I got that for 20, let alone I got this one for £10, which is not bad buy, let alone these go about for £15 to £25 in most stores, even though it's quite funny, a few days after when I got this for £10 in Asda, Smith's was also doing it for £10 as well. But regardless, it was just nice to get this though, even though, like I said, my sister wanted to play in general. Well, the funny thing is though, as you can see by the writing there, I know you can't see it but due to my camera, but this actually was the first game to utilise devices to use for motion controls, because you have like a smartphone device, rather than a Windows phone, and you can't use a Windows phone, this is what I'm trying to say, but if you have like a smartphone device, you can actually use the smartphone instead of requiring to use a Kinect type thing, which is quite useful, because they didn't properly show off this feature until Just Dance 2016, but I do know if most packs don't have this same thing on it, I'm not entirely sure. It's just one time when I was in Granger Games when this was out, and they didn't have that though, and some of the packages have that. I'm not entirely sure on the comm set, but it's nice, however, it's an option though for those people that haven't got a Kinect or any sort of like motion sensor type thing like a PlayStation and camera on the PlayStation 4 and whatnot. Anyways, I'm rambling too much now. But overall, it's just a nice game to get overall. And I actually played this along with Project Spark, because Project Spark had an update where it's completely free now and you can get all the DLCs and whatnot. But in a nutshell, I got like loads of achievements since the update. And then I started getting some achievements on this as well, on Just Dance 2015. And then I reached up to my next gamer score. So I got to 81k gamer score, which I'm actually pleased of, even though I don't concentrate my achievements as much. But however, it's just nice to reach up to my next K overall. And the final thing that I actually picked up, after doing stuff in town, I actually went out with Mum, which was quite nice. Even though I didn't want to do any like food shopping and whatnot, but I had a bit of a chat with Mum, Lola and Susan, something that happened, which I'll mention about in a minute. But yeah, it was just when me and my mum were in Tesco's, my mum spotted this, and this t-shirt, because my mum was tempted to buy this t-shirt for me a few Tesco shots back when my mum saw this, and then she mentioned about it. It's like, oh, I did see this t-shirt, I just didn't know it to get you it, and I was like, oh, you didn't have to get me it, mum, or all that, and we ended up getting me it in the end. But yeah, it's a nice Avengers t-shirt though. I do like my Marvel sometimes, but yeah, it's just a nice thin t-shirt overall that they sold in Tesco's. I might wear this now and again, but yeah, it's just a nice t-shirt overall. But yeah, I'm looking forward to most Marvel things, even though I really want to... Even though Avengers Age of Ultron came on Blu-ray and DVD, but would like a second box set of the Avengers box set for my Blu-ray collection. Yeah, but that never actually turned up, let alone a few vlogs back, a few years back, you know, I wanted to get a second box set of the Avengers with all the second phase films. I'm a noob. I'm just like Iron Man. So yeah, those are some of the pickups I got this past 1 week. Yeah, it was just nice to get some. But like I said beforehand, I'll be getting some other things and in the weeks to come, since I haven't got Rock Band 4 and get some other things. But anyways, the thing that happened also during that day, even I had a great day overall getting some pickups and seeing Mum and whatnot. I had a great, awesome day. I mentioned about this on my Tumblr blog and also about Rock Band 4 and whatnot, like I've read up on my Tumblr blogs. But anyways, the thing is though, that happened after getting my pickups, let alone after getting Just Dance 2015 Asdas, a certain thing happened, which I didn't expect. There was this young teen. I didn't know if she was younger than my sister, because my sister's 15, but she seemed a bit younger than my sister. And the thing is though, I was just checking the game and all that in the back and all that, and I was just about to walk out the store, and then this teen girl was walking past me and then said, "Are you a chav?" I'm like, "A chav? Really?" And all that. And as soon as she was about to go into an aisle, I said to her, "Look, I'm wearing a military cap. This is a military cap," and whatnot. And then she walked off. And then, of course, I had recently got a leather jacket and recently got my hair cut, and I usually wear my military cap and whatnot. But really, I actually been called a chav. Well, even though she said them lines, but still, it made me feel insulted. A chav, really? Do I look like a chav? You what, mate? What are you saying, my mate? I'll smash your light bulbs, innit, mate? McAtees, innit? I could do with McAtees, actually. Me and the lads, you see, we always go for some McAtees, play some FIFA, Call of Duty, and all that. See some nice fit lasses. Yeah? If you're a nice fit lass out there, chances are, I like you and all that. Yeah. This is a bit awkward. But still, if you don't like this, I'll just smash your light bulbs and knock your block off. Take it outside with you, mate. You know? Let me just go and have a pint. And I'll have you. I'll have you, mate. I'll have you. You know? I'll see you in Jeremy Carr show. Bye. You know, it was just stupid, really. And, I just felt insulted. And not say I got too upset, sure, I can easily get put down, let alone most things in Grimsby. You know, I always get asked, like, do you have any pennies, or do you have a fag and all that, let alone stuff like that. I mentioned about this on my Tumblr blog. Regardless, I don't want to ramble on too much. But, yeah, I've just been called a chav. Out of all the things. But yeah, people today, let alone kids in general. But the response out of that, I mentioned, because when I tweeted about this, the response that I got on Facebook was really, really great. I'd like to thank most of yous and all that. It was great. The response that I got was great, let alone kids today. But the other thing that happened, even though it was last week, however, but I forgot to mention about it on my last vlog, let alone I was too busy rambling, saying, I did this and that, follow up on my social network and sites so you know what I've been up to. But I should have mentioned about it on my last vlog, but I mentioned about it on this vlog instead. That is, a certain thing happened in this gaming store that I went into, and I was eavesdropping, because I like to eavesdrop sometimes, that's what I do, but, there was this creepy guy who was a bit large, so to say, and he had long hair and a beard, and he looked like a creepy guy, so to say. And he was chatting to this college lass, because I could tell it was a college lass, because she goes to college because she has the Grimsby Institute type lanyard and whatnot, hibbery-jibbery stuff was what I'm trying to say. But the thing is, though, they had a conversation somewhat about video games, and then this creepy guy was talking about, I have Fallout 4, and I got a review copy type thing, and I can't tell much about it and all that, and, saying about Fallout 4, and, like, in my head, sure, there are, like, people that have review copies and whatnot, but let alone this creepy guy in general, and it got me thinking, why are you lying for? In my head, you know, that meme and all that, you may have heard about that meme on the internet, but I'm just like, why are you lying for? Because you're just a creepy guy trying to chat to this lass and all that, and you put two and two together, and you know what I'm trying to say, but it's just weird in general, just think about it in my head, not like that, but you know what I'm trying to say, it's just stupid, really. But yeah, that happened last week, however. But I just thought I'd mention about it. I forgot to mention about it on my last video. But that happened and just got me thinking. But not overly too much, but you know what I mean. But it's stupid, really. Well, in general. This is why, not saying, I know I have my social problems, I don't usually have socialise as much, but let alone socialising and ended up with stupid people like that in life and all that. You get stupid people, let alone the internet, in real life in general, and the world is a bit meh as it is. I don't want to ramble on too much, but you get what I'm trying to say, let alone my social problems as it is. But other than that, though, I've been fine and dandy this past 1 week. Even though I've been called a chav and never got round to getting Rock Band 4, but I'm looking forward to getting some pickups for the weeks to come. But, yeah, just been doing this and that. I don't want to ramble on too much, let alone talk about my personal life. And I know I have been mentioned about being meh now and again, but I've been keeping myself occupied, which is actually good, let alone doing certain things, but, you know, just good old Stevie T vlogs, me, vlogs, yeah. Anyways, so what videos I'll be doing next week, and there'll be an update for Destiny since they're kind of putting microtransactions, but I might do some gameplay and commentary about that when that hits on Tuesday, and then the day after, even though I got the following work that day, I might not rush it though, and I might do it after work though, and that is the Back to the Future game will be coming out on Xbox, and I actually pre-ordered it, because I pre-ordered it this past 1 week since I got some Microsoft credit with the other pickles that I got this week, which I will mention I got Microsoft credit, but who wants to know that I got Microsoft credit in my pickles? But however, in a nutshell, I actually picked up the Back to the Future game, I actually pre-ordered it, it's already on my Xbox, I just need to wait until it's launched, but I'll be doing some gameplay, maybe after work and not rush it, even though it's just some Xbox One gameplay of the Back to the Future game, even though I watched this video about Telltale Games, and so I'm ranting about Telltale Games, let alone the upcoming Minecraft game that's coming up next week also for Telltale Games, the story mode for Minecraft and whatnot and all that hibber-jibber stuff. Because he was ranting about how the system works for Telltale Games, let alone meant to be doing an episodic type thing and all that hibber-jibber stuff. Anyways, I'm rambling on too much now. But overall, those are the videos I'll be doing next week. Yeah, so that was my vlog for you guys. Hope you really enjoyed it to watch it to the end, even though it's kind of nearly gone past 20 odd minutes. Sorry to say it was a bit long. Anyways, but hope you really enjoyed and watched to the end. Do not forget to follow up on my social networking sites. I know you guys have a nice weekend. I'm looking forward to playing Battlefield. Battlefield? Wrong game, same developer. The Star Wars Battlefront beta with someone, which will be quite nice, he messaged me today, but I was recording the speed log, but I'll be playing with him tomorrow evening, which will be quite nice. Anyways, I'm not going on too much now. I better go now. See you for CC Films.